in campus. Sorry to say that, but we have categories of students in campus. You have the cool kids. Those are kids who don't even know what a help is. They breathe easy in campus. I want to tell you, us from the majority, that attention have never been divided. I'm one of them. I want to tell you, I came from very humble background and rose to the level of chair, main campus. And I really talk passionately about this. I get 35,000. I pay 26,000. What am I remaining with? The little that I'm remaining with, I'm able to get suppliers from Kariobangi to give us what we call KDF in order to sell them, to get profit, to enable me go through the campus. You know, you just don't know the level of poverty that is back there in campus. There are some students, go to those records, there are some students that cannot even afford a three-day meal, or even not three, two-day meal in campus. How are they supposed to survive? Back home, my mom can only give, my mom cooks. My mom cooks in high school. She gets 3,000 shillings in a month. We have siblings at home. How am I supposed to? What I'm trying to say, there are people who are very focused about this, Mr. Chair. I'm not just talking about being diverting attention and the rest. I vied and I'm going to graduate. I've never deferred. I'm a living testimony. So I know there are people. I'm speaking for a number of students there. There are students that when they are given opportunity, they will do wonders with this money. That's why we are saying, Uwezo Fund, coming back to Uwezo Fund, that is why my colleague talked about the proper channels that Uwezo Fund should take. Because this Uwezo Fund and youth funds, they have been in pockets of those who own Kenya. Because you find a youth is being used, that wewe enda pale, upate pesa ulete kwa waze. Get those people behind Uwezo Fund, waze. These people that are pushed to get them, they are just decoys. They're just being used to get this. We need a proper sensitization, a proper channel in which the youth funds and Uwezo Fund can reach the youths pale mashinani. Because when they reach those people, I'm telling you, we'll do wonders. But as for now, we are not going anywhere with Uwezo Fund. It is for those who in Kenya. And for us, we've tried them so much, but we can't get them. Sorry to say that.
Last question, Dave. Okay, let Archbishop ask first, then both of you ask, and then they'll answer those and we.
Sorry for being a little late also. When I came in, you were talking about every county should create employment. If I see the number of universities we have in Kenya and the number of youths we have in Kenya, and having been, at least we members of the steering group, we have been to the 47 counties, I'd like to challenge you, could the university students get together from all these counties and try to have innovation and see what jobs they can create within that county? Because every country, even if you look at the industrial countries, they had what we call either an agrarian or and an industrial revolution. So I think that's the kind of thing we need. So rather than leave it to the county there politically to wrestle with it, what can you students from each county get down to the university, see what potentialities they have, what job creation you can have, what industry can come, and what even agrarian revolution we can have.
Dave.
Thank you, Chairman. Allow me to go back to this issue of help. What is your recommendation? It is not clear to me whether you are saying we should make it a grant or we should have 2% or 3% or give a grace period that is longer. I would like us to have clarity on what your recommendation is about help.
Answer those two, then we finish. If you have anything you want to hand over for the cameras, I'm here. So answer those two.
Thank you so much. To respond to his question, it is good, and that is very encouraging, talking about the youths and the graduates of every county coming together, having innovations, and knowing what to do. But the problem is not ideas. I can assure you that the comrades who are seated here, the kind of ideas and innovations they can bring. You'd wonder if today we are doing an exhibition here today of the ideas. The problem is the funding of these ideas. Even if today we come together, myself and all the other graduates who we are going to graduate together from KU and go to Nakuru County and try to do to bring our ideas together, we need funding so that we can be able to implement these ideas. And now that comes back to this funding, these fundings that are there, the Youth Fund, the UWEZO Fund. They need to be a clear mechanisms of how this money is given. So that if we come and we say we have this idea, we are guaranteed that we can get this money and we can be able to implement our ideas. But as long as the status quo remains, that regardless of the ideas that you have no funding, then we'll not be progressive forward. So the question, the bone of contention here is the funding and not what we can do as youths. There's so much that we can do, but there's so little that is given to us to implement.